Do you feel that sometimes things happen unconsciously, like, you know, maybe you write a page and then, or you write the whole novel basically, and then you look back at it and then you see something that may be connected to your life or that you didn't even realize at the point you were writing it? Or maybe not. I mean, or maybe
it's not. I'm trying to think if there was. I think initially in the very first early draft, there were things that were coming out that I wasn't aware of. But then as I was reading through to try to, because it was a kind of discursive process, I'd write like 30 pages, stop, read those, throw out 15, write some more, throw out a bunch more, kind of go back and forth. And so as I was getting towards the end of the draft, I was like, oh, I did remember that there were things that I put in the book that I didn't necessarily immediately remember were my own story. But it was really, I spend a lot of time with my novels, so I kind of know them really well by the end. And I don't surprise myself too much by the time I get to the end, because I've just tread over it so much. But I think, like you said, that what was going on in my life at that time was even more important than my childhood. That was really what drove the book.
And are there things, because I'm sure there are things that maybe are not connected at all that deal more with creative writing in a way?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we were talking a lot about the process and about how even though what we produce is so different, we kind of have a similar process, that there are multiple things happening from the past, from your reading, from encountering other art, just trying to get through the world in a day, that kind of fall into everything. And that, you know, you pull all the strings, you say, okay, there are these 12 things that were kind of on my mind, but then you look at the piece and you're like, and you can find those pieces, but it's not necessarily as obvious, maybe.
Tell me about the creative process of writing, because I'm not a writer. I think it's much easier to be an artist. How, you have the idea for the book, but then how does the middle and the end come about? How is that process like?
I figure out what's happening while I'm writing it. You know, where I start with the draft is not necessarily where I'm going to end with it, and I don't really worry about that too much. But I usually have a kind of core of ideas or questions or concerns or a character that kind of embodies some of those things. And I just keep writing. I write a lot. You know, I'm a novelist, so I write a lot. I throw out a lot. And I just kind of keep writing until it feels like I'm getting closer to what this character's life is really about at this moment in time. And pulling away from the biography part of the character and putting them in their present and kind of following them through. And some of them, sometimes some scenes, it's like I read the whole scene, I go back 3 weeks later and it's like, no, that has nothing to do with anything that's really happening here anymore, so I cut that out. I read my writing a lot, I revise a lot. And through that process, I kind of figure out what's going on up to a certain point. You know, I'm not the kind of writer who's like, well, I know what the theme of my book is, and the theme is, I can't see it that singularly, because then I'll lose all the characters, I'll lose everything else. I have to really stay inside. And then some characters I have to really work on, like Charlene and Champ. I hated them so much. That I really had to, I went over everything they were in a lot to make sure I wasn't just putting my feelings into it and ignoring what should be happening in the story at the time. And so I know one time somebody asked me about Champ because of the things that he does to Sandrine. And I said, you know, it was, initially what happened was much more severe than what ends up in the book, and that felt wrong. But the hard thing for me was I had to remember as I was writing it that Champ didn't think he was doing anything wrong. He didn't think he was doing anything wrong. I mean, he knew it was not exactly proper, but he didn't really think there was anything wrong. And that's why he could do what he did. And it's the same for Charlene. She didn't feel like she was doing anything wrong when she was so, it's not even strict, she was just kind of mean. off into Sandrine. But she felt she was doing the right thing. She thought, you know, that's what you have to do to raise a child, to go the right way. And you don't want them to be too full in the head about things, and so you have to kind of take them down a few pegs every chance you get. And knowing that kind of parent and disliking that kind of parent, I felt like I had to really be careful that I was representing Shirlene as Shirlene and not putting my fight into her and making sure it was Sandrine's fight and not mine. And so, yeah, that's really my process. I just keep doing it over and over and over. I write a lot.
And then how do you know when, you know, that's time to publish, I guess?
I will finally reach a revised draft that is mostly there. Everything I want are there. Things are moving in the proper direction. There's some tweaking I still have to do, but most of it is there. And then when I have those last three words, I know, okay. This is done. The drafting is done. It's just time to revise and fix it all. So when I got, you know, Small But Safe, I was like, oh yeah, that's the ticket. That's the last period. Yeah, that's the one.
Tell me a bit about your new novel.
I was going to ask that my question. Yeah. Have you found those three words?
Yeah, I have. I found the three words the end of last year. I was like, yes, because I've been working on it a really long time. I originally had the first germ of the idea for the second one before Katrina. And then after Katrina, it was all after Katrina. And I had a couple of, I just melded a few ideas together. And so it's set immediately post Katrina. Everything's still messed up. You know, that time when the stores closed really early, and there's like one gas station, and you turn a corner and there'd be like an EPA truck, you know, and you couldn't get through. That time, that's what, you know, it's really about. And all the garbage that went on. I mean, it was such a time, everyone tried to take advantage of that time, you know. Some people tried to take advantage of that time to get ahead, to say certain people were gone finally from the city, or you know, I remember, and this was, I think I read this article post-Katrina, and that's probably where, that's why the kind of novel kind of centered around the things that it did, but there's this one article about custody post-Katrina, where custody arrangements and custody became a huge problem. Some people didn't know where their kids were because someone evacuated, or someone wanted to get custody, but there's no address anymore, or there's, you know, all these kind of different things. It occurred to me that, I guess because I was a mother, it kind of horrified me to think, oh my God, a catastrophe could happen, and then someone could say, well, guess what? I want your child for myself, and I'm just gonna take her, and there's nothing you can do because the courthouse is closed. You know, I mean, that kind of craziness post-Katrina. So yeah, it's my Katrina novel, but they're all going to be post-Katrina novels because I was saying this the other day. It's like, I'm kind of glad that I wrote Sandrine when I did, because I don't think I could write that novel now because I can't really remember pre-Katrina that well anymore. You know, I think, oh yeah, I used to, and I try to think, oh yeah, I used to go to, and I can't. I'm like, I can't even remember what it looks like anymore, aside from what it looks like now, post-Katrina. It's like, oh, I've almost forgotten it, you know, but